For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Report 1 from your Sample Files folder. I'm going to begin this lesson by entering Page Layout View. To do that, I'll click the center of three icons at the bottom right of the screen. They are Normal View, Page Layout View, and Page Break Preview View. We'll be exploring Page Break Preview View in a later lesson. I'll click the center Page Layout View icon and the view changes. Now I could also do this from the ribbon, but it's a little more cumbersome. To do this from the ribbon, I'd click the View tab and notice there's a Workbook Views group on the left of the ribbon. Using the Workbook Views group, I can change to Normal View and I can change to Page Layout View. But I think you'll find the icon at the bottom right of the screen to be the fastest and most convenient way of entering Page Layout View. Page Layout View is a little bit like Print Preview, as you can see exactly how your worksheet will print on paper. The big difference is that, unlike Print Preview, you can edit a worksheet in this view. And you can also set up many page layout features, including margins, headers, footers, and page numbering. We'll be exploring all of this view's features in coming lessons, but this lesson will focus upon changing the page margins. Those are the blank areas at the top, the bottom, the left, and the right of the screen. Because I'm seeing exactly how the worksheet will print on paper, the missing column problem is now apparent. You can see that the total in column J is printing on a new sheet of paper on its own. In this lesson, we'll solve this problem by adjusting a margin. To adjust the margins, we'll use the rulers. You can see a ruler at the top and left of this page, and that's because this page contains the active cell. You can see that the active cell is currently in cell A1. But if I click in cell J1 to make that the active cell, you can see that the ruler moves to the right and now displays at the top of the second page. But I'll click back in cell A1 to display the ruler across the top of the left-hand page. Now you might not be seeing the rulers, and that will be because another user has switched the rulers off. So here's how to switch the rulers back on again. Click the View tab on the ribbon and notice that in the Show group there's a ruler checkbox. If you click this checkbox, the rulers will appear and disappear. So make sure the rulers are visible. The next thing you need to attend to is the units of the ruler. Depending upon where you are in the world, the ruler may be showing units in inches, centimetres, or millimetres. For this lesson, I've decided I want to set the left-hand margin to exactly 1 centimetre. So it's important that the units shown on the rulers are in centimetres. I can see that my units are currently set in inches. So here's how I'll change them to centimetres. I'll click the File tab on the ribbon and then Options in the left-hand menu bar. Then I'll click Advanced and scroll down to the Display section. And in the Display section, notice there's a Ruler Units option. And at the moment, it's set to Default Units, so it will change depending on which locale I'm in. I'll click the drop-down arrow and explicitly set the ruler units to centimetres. So I'll click Centimetres and OK. And you can see that my ruler is now displaying in centimetres. Now I'm going to adjust the left-hand margin to 1 centimetre. I'll do this by first clicking in cell A1 to make it the active cell. And notice how a portion of the ruler above column A is shaded green. This gives you a visual indication of where the margin begins. I'll now hover the mouse cursor over the intersection of the green and grey sections. And notice that the cursor shape has changed to a two-headed arrow and I can see that the margin is currently 1.78 centimetres. And I want to reduce that to 1.0 centimetres. So I hold down the mouse button and drag to the left. And you can see that as I move to the left, the number of centimetres changes in the tick box. Well, I wanted 1.0, but you'll find that you can't get exactly 1.0 no matter how hard you try. The nearest I can get is 0.98 or 1.01, so I think I'll settle on 1.01 centimetres. In a later lesson, you'll learn how to set these margins precisely. I'll now release the mouse button, and you can see that I've solved the problem. The total column in column J is now printing on my sheet of paper. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Report 2, and as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you may see a message saying that Sales Report 2 already exists, because it's a file name we used in an earlier session, so I'll click Yes to replace it. And you've now completed Lesson 7.2. Use Page Layout View to adjust margins.